This presentation by India Water Portal provides the broad overview of the scheme. This is the second part in the three-part series on Jal Jeevan Mission. For the successful implementation of Jal Jeevan Mission, four-tier institutional mechanism would be set up: national level, state level, district and village level. The national level is called the National Jal Jeevan Mission, which will be headed by a senior officer with a directorate. State level is called the State Water and Sanitation Mission. It will be headed by the Chief Secretary with Principal Secretary in charge of Public Health Engineering Department or Rural Water Supply Department as Mission Director. District level is called the District Water and Sanitation Mission. It will be headed by Deputy Commissioner or District Collector. The Gram Panchayat level is called the Pani Samiti or Village Water and Sanitation Committee or the User Group. The committee will be headed by Sarpanch, Up Sarpanch, Gram Panchayat member, traditional village head, senior village leader, as the Gram Sabha may decide, and may consist of 10 to 15 members, up to 25% elected members of Gram Panchayat, 50% women members, and remaining 25% representatives of weaker sections of the village. The role of the various missions are as follows. The National Jal Jeevan Mission will provide policy guidance, financial assistance and technical support to states and coordinate with other ministries and departments for convergence. The State Water and Sanitation Mission would be responsible for coordination, convergence and policy guidance at the state level. The District Water and Sanitation Mission will ensure preparation of village action plan, finalize a district action plan, provide administrative approval of in-village water supply scheme, ensure availability of funds for resource sustainability and grey water management, approve cost estimates finalized by other committees, coordinate with Gram Panchayats, identify individuals to be trained as master trainers at state level, approve, share reports, success stories, best practices on Jal Jeevan Mission, integrated management information system, conduct campaigns, etc. The Village Water and Sanitation Committee will play a lead role in planning, implementation, management, operation and maintenance of in-village water supply infrastructure, thereby leading to FHTCs to every rural household. Functional household tap water connection in every household will be provided with 3 delivery points through kitchen, washing and bathing area and toilet. Out of the 3, only 1 tap per household will be funded under Jal Jeevan Mission. In this regard, state governments and Union Territory Administration will implement the mission based on the finalized state action plan with timelines to cover all the villages of the respective state and union territories. Each village will be assessed on existing water supply infrastructure by District Water and Sanitation Mission in consultation with Gram Panchayat or its subcommittee. Based on the same, FHTCs will be provided to every rural household by creating in-village water supply infrastructure, including source development under any of the following suggested criterias, that are retrofitting of ongoing schemes taken up under erstwhile National Rural Drinking Water Program for the last mile connectivity, retrofitting of completed rural water supply schemes to make it Jal Jeevan Mission compliant, single village scheme in villages having adequate groundwater, spring water, local or surface water source of prescribed quality, single village scheme in villages having adequate groundwater that needs treatment, multi-village scheme with water grids, regional water supply scheme, and mini solar power based piped water supply in isolated tribal hamlets. Broadly, water supply infrastructure work will fall in two categories. First, creation of in-village infrastructure including source development, strengthening, augmentation, and grey water management. Second, infrastructure for bulk transfer of water, treatment, and distribution systems. The first will be created through single village scheme, multi-village scheme, or solar power-based standalone schemes for scattered areas. The Gram Panchayat or its sub-committee will be responsible to plan, implement, manage, operate, and maintain this. It will include protection of drinking water sources as well as treatment and reuse of grey water. In villages with water quality issues and paucity of surface water sources, especially in drought-prone and desert areas, an approach to transfer bulk water from long distance will be adopted. It will be planned, implemented, and monitored by the Public Health Engineering Department or Rural Water Supply Department or any other board or agency as decided by the State Water and Sanitation Mission or the state government. The components for transfer of water consists of headwork, intake work, tube well, pumping station, distribution network, treatment plants, elevated storage reservoir, sumps, bulk meters, substations for handling bulk water supply, etc. The total estimated cost of Jal Jeevan Mission is Rs. 3.6 lakh crore with central and state share of Rs. 2.08 lakh crore and Rs. 1.52 lakh crore respectively. The fund sharing pattern between the center and state is 90:10 for Himalayan, northeastern states and union territories with legislature, while it is 100:0 for union territories without legislature. For the remaining states, the fund sharing pattern will be 50:50. Central financial assistance for Jal Jeevan Mission will have two sources, namely gross budgetary support and extra budgetary resources. The criteria and weightage thereof to be followed for fund allocation under Jal Jeevan Mission for both the budgetary resources will be as under. Rural population as per last census 30%, rural SC and ST population as per last census 10%, states under Desert Development Program, Drought Prone Areas Program, Hill Area Development Program and Special Category Hill Stations in terms of rural areas 30%, population as per Integrated Management Information System residing in habitations affected by chemical contaminants including heavy metals 10%, weightage for balanced individual household connections to be provided 20%. Up to 5% of such allocated funds to a state or union territory will be utilized for support activities and up to 2% of such funds to water quality monitoring and surveillance program activities. The balance will be utilized to provide FHTCs to rural households. Funds for SCs and STs will be earmarked in the state at least in proportion to their population. Also watch the part 3 of the series. The link for the same is provided in the description box below. For more details visit India Water Portal www.indiawaterportal.org. Thank you for watching.